Hey guys, welcome back to Pokemon. So we just fought some of the sixfold people on the mouse side of the screen corner. So let's go and get back in here. What is happening? That guy's just gone. All right. Well, you battle is different. Pokemon are just tools for battling. You battle, you play things. You're safe with your Pokemon. I don't know if I would say that. I don't think I would say that. Beat it into you. Commemorating Gold Bat. Oh gosh. Good. Rosalia. Oh, that's Shadow Pokemon. You should do like nothing. And nothing. Nice. Ooh. Oh no. That's not gonna be good. Here, just a minute. Okay, I should be able to survive the next one at least. Assuming there's next one. I wouldn't hold the button. That was on me. So what we should do, what we'll do is we'll finish Phenac City. And we'll grind a little bit. And try to get some of the Pokemon's levels up. Maybe clear some of the Shadow Pokemon. I'm trying not to grind too many times. I'd really like to make a one-time session in the middle. You can beat this game, I'm sure, without grinding. There's a lot of Pokemon you can. I just kind of want to use something other than just Jolteon the whole time. Spice it up a little bit so it's not just Thundershock the entire time. Oh, I hadn't selected somebody. Whoops. It's okay. Well, I'm paralyzed, paralyzed, paralyzed. Nice. Hold the button this time. I know it doesn't really do anything, but it's fun. This one's being tough. Maybe it'll miss? I don't know why I keep forgetting to select, it just kind of sits there. So last time I asked what was your favorite Pokemon, what is your favorite Pokemon of the game we have seen so far? Of this game in particular. You can comment that down below. I think for me, so far, probably Mr. Muk. I know that he was a Muk, but yeah, him, I think. That's just not the Pokemon I've seen so far, though. I think it was Grimer at the time. Forgot what I was doing there for a second. I'm holding the button. Finally. Jeez, oh Pete. Take a nice drink of this water. Okay, we're gonna go heal, which we desperately need to do. No, okay, so I'll meet you all back when I get done healing. All right, we're back. So now it's time to face who I'm supposing is supposed to be the harsh one. Real justy impersonator, that's funny. You deal with me first. I love it. It just tells me right where they are. Classic evil villains. Nabra and Sneasel. Right, why are we lagging? Game did not like that. And I think we're back. I don't know what any of that was. All right, let's get back into this. Ooh, almost wrecked. It just makes him harder to hit, if I remember correctly. Yeah. We hit one of them. Ooh. Jeez. It should be a Kadabra next. He's dead. Get wrecked. He's gone. It's previous. And there goes Kadabra. Meowth. Nice. Every Team Rocket wannabe has Meowth. Oh, crap. See if this kills it. Not quite. Good thing I Metal Clawed it as well next. This is what I'm talking about, though. These Pokemon are just super weak. Jolteon can take care of them by themselves, but it makes it difficult when they need to live. So that's why we're going to go, when we're down in Phenac City, we're going to go grind a little bit. There's one. This should hopefully paralyze, and then the other one should help even load it even further. If he lives? Okay, good, good, good. You attacked the wrong one. Once again, I continue to forget to just hit X one more time, or A rather. Yay, first try. He was paralyzed, mud slapped twice, and he was sand attacked once at least. Or he's going to be. Okay, where's he at is the question. I must have missed one. Torkoal and Nuzleaf. Nice. Just about wrecked. I don't know how heavy steel is, so we'll say, I guess. There's one. Goodbye, turtle. Turtle. Swine up. Ah, it's a shot of Pokemon. It's an interesting mechanic, but it's somewhat annoying. The only thing annoying about it is sometimes it's... I don't know. I feel like when I'm catching Pokemon, it's not so bad. It's just mostly when, they're as strong as you. And it's in double battles. It's kind of annoying. Goodbye. Yeah, it did almost nothing. Okay, good to know. Guess he's ground type. I'm not really good with the typings. Get an attack to fall harshly again, and then we'll start on it. I think you can use them like 5 times or something like that. Basically brings it down to 1 HP that takes off. Start roar. I might have to hit him once. I'm trying to avoid that. Nice. Okay. He heard I was gonna hit him. He was like, nope. I will go in there later. I'm gonna go back and heal. I'm losing so many Pokemon, man. Alright, so before I go and rescue those people in the basement, let's check out what's up here, because I was never able to go in here before. Teleper and electric. I'll focus on Electrike first, because last time I fought an Electrike, it kept attracting my lightning attacks, so. Oh, he's just gone. Nice. Spearow. Boom. Tapped him on the bill. Boom. Poked him on the bill. He's just gone. He fought through both of those and managed to make it nice. I didn't know if that would work or not. They're confused, paralyzed, and slightly wounded. Let's see if this works. And it does not. Nice. I'm just going to continue to use that, I guess. I don't really know what else to do with him. Anything I do with, Dolchon's going to just absolutely wreck him. Nice, we're all confused. Gotta go for it. Hopefully I don't have to do three battles in a row. I guess the thing with the shadow Pokemon, the most annoying part is that if I don't catch him now, I'm not getting him. As far as I can tell. I had a frame I could move. I used every bit of that frame to turn my character half a quarter turn. Half or a quarter turn. Isn't that just a deer? I think it almost did more damage to itself. Nice. Nice. Is this gonna be a shadow Pokemon? Yes! He's going on the team. After Duskull, he's the next one. Since I haven't seen Ponyta yet, I don't think Ponyta's on this one. Nice. He immediately pays off. Immediately paid off. Here we go. Fight for Grimer. Man, Paralyze is just doing its work, man. Another shadow wave, take it down just a little bit more. It's not much, just a little bit. Here we go, holding down the button. It's okay, if it can eventually get through the paralyze, it's going to be very, very difficult to hit. Jeez. Crap. That's right. Just let him hit one more time. Knock him down just a little bit more. He finally hit. That would have been tragic. Good. That looks like more endgamey stuff. Let me go rescue the people inside and maybe I'll be able to heal in city instead of having to leave constantly. Go do that. Unless she said I had to go fight the guy. Maybe I do have to go up there and fight that guy. Okay, let's go fight the big bad guy then. Okay. I was about to say, but it wouldn't just taste properly. Hey boy, playtime is over. For you. Graveler. He should be flying type. Yep, there he goes. Copping these nuts. Ooh. I absolutely got wrecked. Nice. And fall over. Nope, that's the shadow bug one. Start wearing down a seal. Do-do-do-do. Nice. Nice. Let's use the de-accuracy moves here. And slightly wounding. One more round of this, and then we'll start the Pokeballs. As this, he'll be about as max fall as he can. Nice. He'll just use Mud Slap to continue to weaken him just a little bit by a little bit. Not necessary, nice. Aw, no, he's just, aw, no, and just done, I guess. Nice. Oh gosh. Admin Snaddle. Lantern and Quagsire. Both water type Pokemon. Against an electric type Pokemon. What? Oh, he must be ground. Maybe he's ground and not water. Why did I think he was in water? Might actually have to use a potion. There goes the ball toy. Definitely take out the fish Pokemon. What? Are they not water either? Oh, maybe they're electric water. Crap. Okay, I guess I'm just gonna use Bite. Apparently that's not effective against this damn fish. As you say, that's not very effective. I Maybe he's ice type. Damn fish is gone. What is this Quagsire type then? If he resists everything I have? Jeez, OP. Is he the every type? Is that even a thing? Oh fuck, I used the wrong one. Well, you wish. Okay, Quagsire died. Holy shit. There's nothing. Pretty soon I'm dead next turn if this doesn't work. Pretty soon I'm dead. It's not gonna work, is it? Nope. And I'm dead. That stupid Quagsire resisted everything I threw at it. Literally was resistant to everything. I understand it. Alright, episode ends when I beat this guy. Generally speaking, I've been trying not to use items in battle. First whiteout. It happens every once in a while. Now I know who can do what. Alright. And I don't have to go through like three battles beforehand. Alright, that's an electric fish. That's an immortal being. Thank you. All right. Unkill, okay, good. It's all right. They're down. That's the shadow. Quags are the immortal being missed. Okay, the immortal being is down. Nice. Super effective, it says. Okay, he's not immune to it at least. Jeez, I'm fucking beat. There's 90% of my health from that one attack. Hero is already last to go, so I really didn't do a whole lot. Here we go. He attempts to start. He's not super wounded. First try. Take it. Better than last time. Ooh. That should take out your buddies. So now it's a 2v1 in the other direction. But all my Pokemon are way less leveled than yours. Oh, that's funny. That's basically what I was using on him. Nice. Jolteon's just fast. Doesn't matter. He's gone. No! He does this weird, like, little dance move. Here. All right, and he dropped a key. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and end it there. It was quite fun. First whiteout of the mission against Quagsire, of all things. But I will see you all in the next one. Thank you all for watching. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe down below. Check out other playthroughs I did, both solo and with others. And remember to keep enjoying life. I'll see you all in the next one. See ya.